Good evening. Welcome to Current Affairs. Today, we'll be looking into various topics. First, I would like to discuss with you regarding DA, that is Dearness Allowance. That is very much there in the news because for the central government employees, the government has increased it by 1%. So that we'll be discussing. And next, another important point is that so there is a scheme called VISHWAJEET. Regarding that also we will have a discussion. And another important point is that the finance ministry has given a nod to go for minting. So to go for minting of coins, currency notes are printed, coins are minted. So new coins are going to come up into the market. That will be 5 rupee currency coins and 100 rupee coins. And on this one, the portrait of one of the very, very, very important political leaders is going to be present. And who is that political leader? One of the very, very, very famous one. So we'll be discussing that one after a period of time. So later we'll also have a discussion regarding Chakmas. So these are the refugees. These are the refugees from Bangladesh during 1960s. Meaning there is one Chakmas, Buddhist and some Hindus, they fled to India. And since then they are being staying in India as refugees. So today the government has decided to provide citizenship to those sections. So regarding that also we'll be discussing. But first of all, let me discuss with you regarding the Dearness Allowance. What exactly is this? This is a part of the salary structure of the employees. But what is this? Apart from the basic salary, employees are also given this Dearness Allowance. Basically, this Dearness Allowance is meant for making the employees to meet the needs in the market, so which are occurring because of the inflation. What happens all of a sudden are gradually the prices of the commodities will increase. Similarly, in tune with that, you need to increase the salary of the employees. So that what will happen, that will not be affecting the families of the employees. That is the reason why a concept called Dearness Allowance has been introduced. And that Dearness Allowance, the government will keep on revising every 6 months. And yesterday also the government decided so to increase this Dearness Allowance by 1%. So apart from this, government also decided, the decisions were taken in the cabinet with respect to private sector employees. All these years the gratuity has been restricted at 10 lakhs maximum 10 lakhs and now it has been doubled. Right, so now it has been doubled, and for this reason, amendment bill is going to be introduced in the parliament. And once that is accepted, this gratuity will be doubled. Doubled meaning it will be going to maximum 20 lakhs. So all these things we'll be discussing now. First, I'll show you the document with respect to Dearness Allowance. Look at this now. And another important point I would like to tell you. So when the prices of the commodities will increase, it will affect common man. It will also affect the people who are employed. It will also affect the people who already retired from the government service. So they are given something called pension. But when you are revising this Dearness Allowance with respect to the current employees, that will be automatically revised even to the employees who got retired. So whenever you are revising it, when you are paying more, that will be affecting the exchequer, meaning that will be a burden on the government, but still government has to go for it because you need to take care of your employees and you should also take care of the people who already worked and got retired. Am I clear? And current people who are working, it is called Dearness Allowance, and the people who already retired, it is called Dearness Relief. Right? So now, Kindly remember this. I'll be showing the document now. Look at this. So this is called a dearness relief for pensioners. Dearness allowance is a cost of living adjustment allowance which the government pays to the employees of the public sector as well as the pensioners of the same. Of the same means of the public sectors. Public sector means government employees. DA has been included to compensate for price rise or inflation in a particular financial year, and hence it is revised twice every year. Hope you got it. Very, very important. When the prices will increase, the inflation occurs, and the inflation is caused because of the various reasons. Reasons are plenty. That is the reason why it is safe for the government to protect the interest of the employees by revising this DA twice every year. And whatever the dearness allowance that has been increased, it will be coming into effect retrospectively. Look at this. So on September 12th 2017, that is yesterday, DA has been hiked by 1% and is applicable retrospectively from July 1st 2017, meaning we are in the month of September and now the decision has been taken to increase this. When we say it will be applicable retrospectively, meaning from previous dates, and that date was July 1st 2017, and that will be given to the employees in the next month salary, meaning this DA, increased DA of 1%, will be calculated from July 1st 2017, and that will be given to the employees. Kindly remember, this DA is revised twice every year. Please remember this. And the government also decided to double the maximum gratuity payout to private sector employees from 10 lakhs to 20 lakhs. Remember this one, all these days it is 10 lakhs maximum. And now it is going to be 20 lakhs. For this reason, the payment of gratuity amendment bill 2017 will be introduced in the parliament. So it will be introduced, it will be passed, president will sign, that is considered to be amendment act, and that is leading to increasing this gratuity maximum to 20 lakhs. Look at this. This is what the question I was telling you. The finance ministry has notified the minting of commemorative rupees 100 and rupees 5 coins to mark the centenary of popular politician, and the leader was important one, right? Commemorative in the memory of, meaning he's a person already passed away, right? And the decision has been taken, and very soon they are going to come up 100 rupee coins and 5 rupee coins, and this particular person's portrait will be there. Is it N.T. Rama Rao? Hopefully you're all aware of this name. He was the former chief minister of Andhra Pradesh. Jayalalitha very recently passed away. She was the chief minister for Tamil Nadu. M.G. Ramachandran, chief minister for Tamil Nadu. Rajiv Gandhi, prime minister for India. Clear? Look at this. All the four people have passed away, and answer is option C, that is M.G. Ramachandran, right? So M.G. Ramachandran took birth in the year 1917, right? And this is the centenary year for this great person, and very well known. And well known for the people of Tamil Nadu as well as the people of entire India. And he was an excellent person in the field of cinema. Later he entered into politics. People followed him. People, you know, this is so many people followed this great person, and he is remembered even today like anything. And that great person Of course, he passed away in the year 1987. So in the memory of that person, the government has decided to go for it. And some people are criticizing, is there any political angle for this? Obviously, the decision has been taken by the government of India. And the government of India, the major political party is BJP, NDA. Right? And NDA, BJP is there. So now, all of a sudden, you started recollecting the memories of M.G. Ramachandran. Right? Obviously, there is a political angle because BJP wants to establish itself in Tamil Nadu. But the reason may be anything. And this is a great, very great person, Mr. M.G. Ramachandran, and people of Tamil Nadu very affectionately calls him MGR. MGR, and in the memory of that person, the coins are going to be placed. Please remember this one. Answer is M.G. Ramachandran. Look at this. Okay. Look at this. Answer is C. You may read the question once again if you want. I'm going ahead. M.G. Ramachandran was popularly called MGR. He took birth on January 17th, 1917 and passed away on December 24th, 1987. Now, Supreme Court on corrupt representatives. So what exactly is this? Representatives means our representatives in the parliament, our representatives in the state legislative assemblies. If you look at some of the politicians, even today also some people are present in the parliament and state assemblies. I will show you the figures now. These politicians, they are considered to be corrupt and they are amassing the wealth like anything. Elections are held every 5 years, we know that. And whatever the assets that they are showing in the previous election, that assets are becoming double, triple, sometimes it is becoming 10 times more than what they have by the next elections. How is it happening? No, there is no body so to question this one. And there is a mechanism for declaring the assets, they are declaring the assets. But the point is that from where they have accumulated so much wealth, how is it possible for those people? So when you are there in the public life, and when you are working for the people of the country, so how is it possible for you to enmass so much? And when the petition was filed in the Supreme Court took it very, very seriously, and Supreme Court asked the government to establish a mechanism where the from where exactly they are enmassing this wealth. How exactly? What are the methods that you are following? That should be investigated very thoroughly. Otherwise, what is happening? So they are getting elected and they are holding that power, and by using that power, so they are following the corrupt methods, and ultimately the people of the nation, so they are being fools. And it should not be it should not be happening in future. So that is a basic idea with respect to the Supreme Court. Right? I'll show you the number. And even today also, some people are present over here, and the number has been presented to the Supreme Court by an NGO, non-governmental organization. So look at the numbers, please. So this is related to wealth disproportionate to their known sources of income. If you have the source, if you are enmassing something, that's no problem. But this is disproportionate. Known sources is something, but your assets are disproportionate. The apex court was hearing a petition. Saw the center gave details of probe into assets of 26 Lok Sabha members, 2 Rajya Sabha members, and 215 MLAs across the country. So many people, they are enmassing the wealth like anything. Enmassing is not a problem, but it is disproportionate to their known sources of income. Am I clear? Next. Vishwajeet, this is what I was telling you. Vishwajeet stands for Conqueror of the Universe. Last year, That is, in the year 2016, the government has launched this particular project, and the aim of the project is to catapulting Indian Institutes of Technology, IITs, important, to the top league of global academic rankings. So, my dear friends, in the examination, they may ask you, what is this VISHWAJEET project? Okay, very, very important. This is related to enhancing and keeping our IITs at the in the global rankings. Very, very, very important. And of course, the government decided to release lots of amount for this, but unfortunately, that is not being happening. So the expected changes that are going to take place in the coming 5 years may not happen because government is not releasing the money. And this is what is expressed by some of the professors and other intellectuals in this particular field. But otherwise, for you, for the examination point of view, what is VISHWAJEET project? Right? Next. Next, citizenship to Chakma refugees. So we have our neighbor, that is Bangladesh. But this is the story that is related to 1960s. At that time, it was not Bangladesh, but it was East Pakistan. So because of this political issues and religious issues in today's Bangladesh, or then called East Pakistan, some Buddhists and Hindus and Chakmas, you know, so they have crossed the borders and they have entered into India, and they are popularly called Chakma refugees. And these people, they started staying in different parts of the country in India, especially the northeastern states. And since then, there is a problem with these people. The number is more than 1 lakh today. The number is more than 1 lakh today, and the government has decided to provide. Government has decided to provide citizenship to the Chakma refugees. Clear? Kindly remember this one. So Buddhists were there, Hindus were also there in that particular one. But the point is that why they should be provided the citizenship, and the government took a lot of time for providing this. Is that okay? And the decision that has been taken by the government today is contradicting the decision of the government to deport to Rohingya their people back to Myanmar. Meaning, on one side you are showing your humanity, on the other side you want to send them back. But the government is very firm that the government is going to send Rohingya people back to Myanmar because of the security issues. That is the reason why lots of vigilance has been enforced in the northeastern states today, and especially in Manipur and all the border states. A lot of vigilance is there. Ultimately, security of the nation is very, very important, and that's what the government is doing. And it's always there in the news, Chakma refugees, they belong to which country? Answer is Bangladesh. Please remember this. This is a very, very old issue, 1960s. Look at this now. The Union government decided to give citizenship to over 1 lakh Chakma, Hajongos, Buddhists and Hindus who fled to India in 1960s. They fled to escape religious persecution in Chittagong Hill area of Bangladesh. And the Chief Minister of Arunachal Pradesh, Mr. Pema Khandu, said very clearly that these people, once they are given the citizenship, they would be free to buy land anywhere in the country if they want, but they will not be permitted to buy land in Arunachal Pradesh. This is a new issue, and a new tussle will come into picture. Not exactly new, but always there in the news. But now, since the chief minister of one important state has given this statement, so remaining chief ministers will also be talking in the same tune. Issues are there, the government has to try to address it. So when you are trying to address a few issues, new issues will be coming up, and the government has to address even those new issues also. So this is how the government has to function. And remember, so the last topic what we discussed is the related to Chakma refugees, and these were from Bangladesh, right? And that's all for the day. And I thank you so much for being with me this evening, and I wish you all very, very good luck. Take very good care of yourself, and I see you tomorrow with more current affairs. Thank you so much. Good night.